Made history as Michigan's first blind Supreme Court justice, and he's been sitting on the bench since 2014. Joining me this morning, the Honorable Richard Bernstein. Good to see you. Thank you very much for being here.
Good morning. I'm so happy to be here, and thank you so much for talking about these issues.
Absolutely. You have a special event you want to talk about. We'll get to that shortly, but first, of course, we have to talk about what's in the news, which is state by state, these abortion cases, abortion rights, women's rights. Where do you, within what you can actually discuss, where do you stand on this?
Well, I think what's interesting is that I think, you know, not commenting on specific cases, I think what is always critical for the law is it has to be stable. And I think the essence of stare decisis is a critical component that always plays a role, which means that people have to see the law outside the political process. People have to see the courts as stability. And that usually just means that courts really have to kind of remain in a consistent basis to allow for structure to always uphold.
All right. The Supreme Court here in Michigan, we're kind of a purple state. Do you think that the court reflects the constituents?
Actually, we have a wonderful court, and I think what's great about our court is there's no politics that really takes a role in the court. Because remember, we have 8-year terms. That's a long time. And I think what you find with this court is that people really like each other. People enjoy each other. I would say some of my absolute closest friends are my fellow justices. And I think what you'd find on our court is that people might disagree over specific issues time to time, but it's never personal. And what's great about our court is that what people should always know is that all the justices remain steadfast to the law. And I think that's critical. The judiciary is a stable, consistent branch that people should have confidence and pride in.
A recent ruling from the court is setting up a bigger debate over retiree benefits and pensions. Last month, the court ruled that Macomb County can slash benefits when under union contract. Can you give us some insight into how this could possibly be? If I was a retiree in Macomb and, you know, I was counting on a certain fixed benefit and then it got slashed, I'd be pretty upset.
Well, what's interesting is that, you know, and rightfully so, but I think what we have to do is we have to adhere to the law. And I think there was some U.S. Supreme Court decisions that I think are implicated by that. But ultimately, I think if you look at the court's reasoning in it, you'll see that, you know, you had a disagreement on the court. But I think what's happening is that if you look at the current opinion that came out, I think what you're going to find is that justices kind of followed the law. They did what basically the law required. There was some disagreement as it pertained to kind of our interpretation of the law. But, you know, I think several more justices saw the law in one way and other justices saw the law in the other way. And that's the whole idea of having a give and take and a back and forth and an overall legal discussion. And that's what the court's supposed to do. So I think if people read the decisions, you'll see the majority decision and you'll see the dissenting decision. And I think you'll be able to see the back and forth and the exchange that kind of took place. But it's all grounded in legal interpretation and people followed the law to the best of their abilities, even though we might have disagreed.
Tell us about the event you have coming up.
So this is such a wonderful event. This is for the Jewish Vocational Services. And Jewish Vocational Services does such incredible work. They help people find jobs, people who struggle, people who have disabilities. The whole idea of Jewish Vocational Services is to allow for folks like me, people who are challenged, people who have disabilities, people who face struggle in life, to have an opportunity to find work. And the beauty of this event and the beauty of Jewish Vocational Services is that you find if you hire a disabled person or a person who has challenge or difficulty in their lives, what you're going to find is you're going to find a person with such passion, such idealism, such spirit, such vitality. They make the greatest employees that you're ever going to come to find. Because I think what JVS shows is that no matter what your struggle in life is, in many situations, people's bodies might be infirmed, but their spirits have no limitations and can truly soar if given an opportunity and given a chance, and we do that through work.
Excellent. That's Thursday at Motor City Casino at 11 a.m. Tickets are available.
Absolutely. Please come. And if you're an employer, please look out to JVS and see if you can start employing some disabled people. You will not be disappointed. You will be inspired and excited to have them working with you.
Your Honor, thank you very much for
being
here.
Thank you. And thank you for covering this. I love Channel 4 and I love spending time here. So thank you for having me back.
It's our pleasure.